Hey guys, so today we are going to learn about a very interesting force, that is gravity. Gravity is a force which almost helps universe to function. We all know what basically gravity is. But in today's video, we are going to take the concept of gravity much deeper. So let's see what really gravity is. Welcome to Bright Brains. This is Girish and today we are going to discuss about gravity. Gravity is a force which attracts two objects towards each other. It is present in the phenomena from falling of a pen towards the ground or two planets attracting each other. On Earth, gravity plays a very important role. It keeps us holding towards the ground and of course it gives us weight. Gravity is an intensive force, but as you will go out or away from the force, away from the field, this force will go on decreasing for you. There will be less force acting if you are on the earth. There will be a lot more force of acting if you are on the earth, and if you will go out of the earth, that is in space, the less force you will feel rather. So gravity is a very vast concept and it has a very vast history. Not only Newton and Einstein, but it's from the Greek philosopher, the great Greek philosopher, I must say, you might be knowing his name, Archimedes. From his time to the Galileo's time, when Galileo Galilei in the last of 16th century rather, and the starting of 17th century, Galileo Galilei revolutionized this concept of gravity. What Galileo Galilei did, he performed an experiment. He took two balls, one was much heavier than the other one, and dropped them from the same height towards the ground. From the Leaning Tower of Pisa, a very famous tower of that time. And what he showed from that experiment, that the two balls, what happened with them, the two balls fall at the same time on the ground, at the same instant of time they've fallen on the ground, and it shows that gravitational acceleration acts same on the both the objects, rather the weight doesn't matter here. And to experiment on this only, Galileo Galilei dropped these two balls. And on that time, in the 16th century, we were not known about gravity. And Galileo Galilei was also not knowing what is gravity. So he was unable to explain why this happened. But after that, experienced from the Galileo's concepts, Newton, Sir Isaac Newton, formed or discovered gravity. He discovered gravity in his papers and wrote first time what really gravity is. You might be knowing his universal law of gravitation, which is the very famous law in the Newtonian mechanics. And this law is usually used for carrying out each and every experimental value of gravity in the physics field, okay? And what he told in his concept, rather, Newton, what he told in his universal law of gravitation, that every two objects attracts each other, and to attract each other, they are directly proportional. The gravitational force is directly proportional to the masses and inversely proportional to the distance. Means the masses of both the objects, means if both the objects have the same masses, they will attract each other with the same gravity. And rather, if they are kept at a very longer distance, the gravitational force will decrease for them. And that is why it's inversely proportional for in the inversely proportional with the distance. So this was what Newton told in his Newtonian mechanics or universal law of gravitation. But after that, Sir Albert Einstein, a great scientist, a great physicist, he gave in his general theory of relativity that gravity is not attracting things only. It is acceleration and deacceleration of the objects. it is formed due to the curvature of space and time. And this concept or this definition is much applicable for what gravity is, or this explains gravity much deeply. Okay, now you will ask, where do we use this Einstein general theory of relativity? So as I told first only, we use the Newton's mechanics law, which is the universal law of gravitation, which constant is given here. As you can see, what is the universal gravitational constant? So we use this because this is much comparatively simple to calculate the values of gravity in the physical phenomena on the Earth. Rather, gravity or the Einstein general theory of relativity is usually applied in the space operations. Okay, so now let's see the intensity of gravity, how strong it is really. So as I told you, the gravity is an intensive force, but it is the most weakest of the four fundamental interactions or the four fundamental forces. It is almost 10 raised to the power 39 times weaker than the strong force, and 10 raised to the power 36 times weaker than the electromagnetic force, and it is almost 10 raised to the power 30 or 31 times weaker than the weaker than the weak interactions. Okay, so this was about the weakness of gravity. Rather, it is a very intensive force, it brings objects together, but it is not the strongest of the fundamental forces. Gravity is now studied at the quantum level also, but we have not found rather any influence of gravity in the particles or the subatomic level at the quantum level. But researchers think that there was gravity existing when the universe began to form during the Big Bang. It existed as quantum gravity. It also existed as gravitational singularities, means it caused interactions between two quantum particles or two quantum objects, and because of this only we can't experience this gravitational interaction or gravitational influence today in the any of the quantum particle, but we have to find it, and because of that we have made a new field, which is quantum gravity, and we are studying how the gravity is influencing particles in the quantum level. Rather, we have not found any influence, but researchers are researching on it, and scientists are also trying to find it answers. So today I told you what gravity is, and almost I told you what was the history of gravity. I told you that not only Newton but Einstein, it was from the ancient time, from the Archimedes time, he told the center gravity of triangle. He discovered that only center of gravity of a triangle. And then after that Galileo Galilei's experiment, and after that then the Newton found it. So this was all about classical gravity, but in the next video I will explain what is quantum gravity and what researchers are researching on the gravity in the quantum level. Okay, now I will say you that how I told that during Big Bang gravity is creating everything. So during the Big Bang, it is believed that during the Big Bang, when there was big cloud formations or dense hot clouds, that time what happened, due to this gravitational force, the clouds collapsed and formed stars. These stars then, because of the gravitational force, attracted things towards them and formed solar systems, and these solar systems then formed galaxies. Means you can say that the gravity was existing from quantum level towards the now the macroscopic level, but in today's physics, in today's day, we can only find gravitational interactions in the macroscopic, that is the larger objects or the larger phenomena or the surrounding phenomena that you can see from your eyes, and we can't find it in the quantum level. So in the next video I will explain you what is quantum gravity. So till that, keep exploring, keep reading about gravity, and keep watching Bright Brains. Thank you.